very best of luck and good luck about
the name. So it's all turned around in the last year and a half. He looked to be going nowhere. And suddenly Thaxton has two titles. But they're on the line tonight against Burke and this burgeoning career, which he says will take him towards the world crown.
Well, he certainly looks very, very fired up, Thaxton. He's going to want to impress very much here.
Billy Graham's been teaching Burke to expect the early onslaught. Switch hitter like so many in the Ingle camp. From Norwich and spends the weekend here during the week up with Brendan Ingle in Sheffield.
Watch the edge, Bobby, watch the edge. The head coming there. Well, you can tell they're both very, very keyed up. Neither man really getting any sort of edge or getting through at the moment.
Coiled up like a spring.
Just has to keep nice and compact. He can't allow himself to lift his chin, give Thaxton any room to get through with his big swinging punches.
Burke's body language early on has looked good. He hasn't looked overall.
Trying to keep his composure. Thaxton just lunging a little, trying a little too hard. Burke making him miss well there.
He looks a little stiff early on, Thaxton.
Yes, I think that's the well you're from. He wants to impress so very much. He knows he can punch, and he could just try for the big punch a little too hard. Burke's a very experienced campaigner.
Good job. Good jab from Burke as Thaxton came in. Good round, but not the explosive one that the Norwich fans were looking for. You're talking to. Reckon he just showed you that round. There's his mother, who's done so much in getting the crowd in. A packed crowd it is too, and all of them wanting Jon to win.
Yes, he probably just shaded the first round. He's a little tense, trying a little bit too hard, but there wasn't a great deal coming back from Burke. He was being very careful, and you know, Burke may want to, you know, just be steady in the early rounds and look for it to go in the later rounds and do his best work later.
Well done. Here we go.
Many ways they've come up in completely the opposite route. Thaxton has come up very quickly. Burke's come up the hard way. A very good win in his sixth fight, where he beat Pat Barrett, who went on to win the British and European title. But men on, it's Barrett who made the move, and Burke, his career stood still.
Burke just landing with a decent right hand as they come out of their little clinch there. So Burke, certainly, he's not overwrought. He's been a little careful, but that's very experienced of him.
Good right from Burke, flush on the chin.
That was a beautiful punch, really slotted that through, just found the gap in the guard, and that was a hard punch. And that was a nice sharp punch from Burke.
Well, there was immense confidence behind Thaxton before this fight started from the crowd. Of course, from Thaxton himself, but not quite so much now. Better there, though.
A little messy at times with the clashing style. Good left hook there from Thaxton. He's got to know the orthodox stance. He does often box southpaw, can't switch well.
But a lot of this roundhouse stuff from Thaxton isn't working, but well prepared for it.
Well, Burke has to keep nice and compact, don't leave the chin open, but fire his shot straight through the middle, straight through the middle.
Again, but for the most part, he's not getting to Burke.
Well, defensively, Burke's been doing quite well, and he's landed with some nice counters. Burke, he's been very composed in this round.
Burke's doing okay. It's a close fight at the end of round two.
He's just allowing Burke to counter well.
Thaxton changing time after time, orthodox to southpaw, but not getting home enough.
impose himself on Burke here. Thaxton trying to rough him up and get close.
Paul Thomas telling Thaxton to watch his head the last time, but Burke's round again.
Friday afternoon in the Super League. Wigan against St. Helens, Sky Sports 1 at 2:30. Here, it's really brewing up. Thaxton against Burke, dual title showdown, round 4 coming up with Glenn and Simon Reid.
Thanks, Paul, yes. It's not the fight that a lot of the fans came to see. They thought it would be easy and quick for Thaxton. We had our doubts and they're proving right. Burke is the governor out there at the moment.
Yes, he's boxing well, Burke, nice and cool, not wasting anything, but Will Thaxton has this big punch and that could change things at any time.
Good right again. Flush on Thaxton's chin. That one just bounced off. We know that Thaxton's got not just the power, which we talked about, but the character to come back. We're going to need it here. At the moment, it's a bit of a lesson going on, and it's coming from Burke.
Burke landing the better punches there, and Thaxton blindly trying the left hook as he came out of the crowd. That's the punch that Burke has to watch for. He has to keep his concentration at all times, Burke.
Thaxton fighting with his mouth gaping open, but then that's his style. Doesn't mean to say it's tricky child, he's phenomenally fit.
Right overcut there from Burke, still nice and cool, boxing well.
Brendan Ingle pleading with Thaxton to land the jab a little more. Obeying orders, trying to get the jab first off.
Yes, they just want him to relax a little bit, start getting his punches off looser. Again, constant switching of stances from Thaxton.
Much more on his toes. Quicker to the punch in this round. Just throwing Burke a little off the rhythm that he created in the third round. This is a better round for Thaxton.
As he's just loosening up a little more and throwing a few more punches. Not all landing, but he's getting through more.
Yes, the Norwich fans a little happier after that. So Thaxton coming back better with some more unorthodox work. The most part with the southpaw jab, but some good lefts as well. There are the statistics so far. Burke with a much better success rate and more quality work. But it's an even fight, Glenn.
Yes, very much so. We saw, you know, very little between the punches landed. And, you know, on my card, I've got it level, really poised at this stage. Thaxton in the last round, I give him the round. He just started to loosen up a little more. And that's how I have it, 38 points each.
Good left from Burke as Thaxton came in. I shook him up, didn't hurt him too much. He's gone back to the style he was producing in the third round. Going for these big lefts as he comes in.
Again, good defensive work from Burke there. He's boxing an intelligent fight. He's waiting for Thaxton to lead and looking for his counters.
Shows you what adrenaline can do for a fighter. His last fight, Burke was really unimpressive against the Brown Coleman in Manchester. At last, something for the crowd to get fired up about from Thaxton.
Because he's just starting to land the left hooks. He landed the first one, was a good one. Second one, Burke took on the gloves.
Those who saw Burke that day against Coleman wouldn't have given him too much of a chance in Norwich against Thaxton, yet the big time has brought the best out of him.
Again, Thaxton lands with a new decent left hook. He's getting closer into range, starting to connect a little more.
And on the back of the head, right? Last minute of the fifth, still very difficult to separate them. I don't know quite what he's going to do behind that southpaw stance sometimes. He used to be a kickboxer, and you... Just on occasion, do you think he's shaping up for a kick?
Yes, some of his moves are not the most orthodox boxing moves.
Watch the head, Thaxton. Come on, now.
Well, this one, very, very close on. Both of them having little shades of success. Nobody really standing out as the winner in the round.
Quiet around that time. And I don't know about you, Ben, I find it very difficult to separate them in that round.
Yes, they would have probably given that an even round. They both had little flashes of success, but nobody really took over in the round. And I think probably an even round.
He turned pro in January 87 when Thaxton was just 12 years old. Here's the big left hand early on in the round.
Yes, he just waited there, nice little counter. He waited for Thaxton to lead and then just caught him with a little left, it was a good one. Saxon had his own success there, just leaping in still a little bit. Burke, for the most part, quite good defensively.
It's the left that got the crowd on their feet. That wasn't quite on the target. The other big Norwich boxer, Herbie Hyde, watching on. To round six, 12 rounds, remember, for the WBO and IBF Intercontinental light welterweight titles. Thaxton's the champion.
It's still a very, very close fight. No man really has been able to dominate yet.
Right, and that would have had its effect on Burke. And Thaxton's corner think that they've hurt him, and pleading him to use the uppercut a little bit more. Important stage of the fight. Thaxton beginning to connect. Let's see how Burke stands up to this. A cut over his left eye. It's running down the side of the head. It's not going to be, as it is at the moment, any real threat to him. But Thaxton is a real threat to him, and he's getting stronger.
Yes, he's starting to do more. Starting to find the target better in this round. A lot less coming back from Burke here. He's not managing to get the good counters in.
And important moments here for Burke. And Thaxton lands again. Burke does well to keep him off. This is a big round for the man from Norwich.
As you can tell, he's starting to grow in confidence. He's starting to take a few more risks and go for Burke more and more.
Again, the heads banging together. It's the heads that open up the cut over the left eye. It's to the side of the eye, high up, and no real threat. But he's taken a bit of a grilling this round, has Paul Burke. Good counter. Kickboxer and wrestler. Burke not amused. Big round for Thaxton. Over the left eye. You can see it's to the side of the head. Wedge in itself caused too much damage. But it was, looked like it was the punch that the right hook landed.
Yes, it was. That was swiping. It was a swiping downward sort of punch. It could leave a mark like that. But a problem in this fight is the heads are coming dangerously close. So both fighters have to watch that.
I think the head might have contributed to it as well. But Thaxton, for the first time, has exerted his authority on this.
As you just feel he's, you know, as he's getting tired, he's just starting to relax a little more, starting to throw more punches, getting into the fight, not as tense.
Blood flowing again from the cut, but again down the side, not into his eye. Just the side of the head. Yes, Paul Thomas getting a little anxious about the head. They both weighed in.
Yes, when they're getting close, they're dipping their heads down. Burke knows he has to do that. He can't lift his head in the air when they're coming close, or his line will be caught by one of the hooking punches from Thaxton.
And doing better and better out of that southpaw stance.
But for the first time, he's just starting to take over a little bit, just do a little bit more and have better success in there. From this stage in the fight now, where Burke has to be a little more positive.
Good shot, got through. This is essentially the key moments in the fight. Thaxton threatening to take over. Can Burke stay with him? You feel he has to do some damage of his own right now, Burke.
Yes, it's a stage in the fight where he could just let it slip away and allow Thaxton to command control. This is where Burke, you know, it's about this spot where he needs to pick it up. He tried there, sorry Simon, he tried there with the left right, Burke, but only one of them got through. He needs to do more than that.
Thaxton's looking good right now.
Everywhere you look this weekend on Sky Sports. Sky Sports 3, Friday night football at 7. Barnsley against West Bromwich Albion. Barnsley still in the hunt for an automatic promotion spot. Thaxton against Burke here in Norwich now. Here comes round 8.
And we have Paul Burke here a couple of rounds down against the home man Jon Thaxton, defending his WBO and IBF Intercontinental titles. That's the scorecard so far. You can see there's been a change round from round four.
Yes, the two rounds lead for Thaxton, just starting to get on top a little. Burke's very experienced, he'll know what he has to do, which is whether physically he can do that. But he needs to start landing with better punches.
This is probably not the fight that Burke expected from Thaxton. Thaxton, unorthodox, going to the southpaw lead, jinking in and out, occasionally landing the flurries.
Yes, I'm sure he's watched Thaxton several times, and you know, as well as being a big puncher, you know, he changes things around. But he's really loading up now. He's looking for the big one.
Better work from Burke. Lovely jab.
That's what Burke really should do a lot more of, just to keep Thaxton off balance.
Great looking left hook. Burke felt that. He shakes his head, but his legs betrayed him. He wobbled all right. And Thaxton has him rocking just for a moment.
First, that looked the first time that he was hurt by a significant punch, Burke.
And the crowd sends it. And Thaxton closing in on his prey now, inside the final minute of this eighth round.
This Thaxton just had Burke on the run a little bit there.
First time Burke's been really hurt in this fight. Calling on him to come in and finish this off. More dangerous moments for Paul Burke. He's close to going. The bell may well save him, but you can see he's all over the place.
That was a good right hand, and he was on unsteady legs there. He was looking to try and grab Burke.
And never has the bell sounded sweeter for Paul Burke than that one. Damage is being done all over the place now. Thaxton's hot, and Burke wilted there for the first time.
Yes, that was a bad round for Burke. He was hurt a couple of times during that round. Good work from Thaxton. He's now found his rage. He's getting the punches in. There's that good left hook. And Burke just stumbles backwards. The legs almost give way. He's give a little smile there, but he was hurt by that. And this is later in the round when he was hurt again with a good left hook from Thaxton. Just doubling it up, and he's just a little bit on the run there, Burke.
And throughout that last minute, Brendan Ingle shouting at Thaxton and saying, you can finish this right here. Four rounds to go. And the left hook pushed him back again once more.
Yes, he got up a little early, could have maybe took a little bit more respite. But the power of Thaxton is now beginning to tell.
And there's real unease about Burke now, and his legs wobbling all over the place. It's close to the end, Paul Thomas having a good look. The Thaxton corner telling him to wade in now with both fists, and he's doing that brave stuff from Burke. But is this the last hurrah?
Well, he's showing great heart here, Burke, fighting back. But he just has this, Thaxton just has the extra power, the extra strength.
Thaxton landed there and looks at him as if he was amazed that Burke was still standing. But only for a split second, and back he comes. And that's it. It's all over. And rightly so. Paul Thomas calls a halt. And this bulldog of a man, Jon Thaxton, has held on to his titles in very impressive fashion. And they love it here in Norwich.
Yes, he's really got the crowd going with that. That was a good finish. At the end, it was just the physical strength and the punching power. And it was just a matter of time. Burke started to wilt, and he kept the pressure on. And it was good pressure from Thaxton. He knew he had his man going there, and he didn't let him off the hook. And credit to Paul Burke. He tried to fight back. He was very brave, but he's just beaten by a bigger and stronger man.
How good is he, Glenn? He's not a stylist, he wouldn't win anything in a coach's manual, but there's real power there, and there's bad intent.
Yes, at times he's a little bit unorthodox and a little bit crude, but he's still very young, he's learning with every fight, and he's a very powerful, both physically and also punching-wise. So he can do a lot of damage, he can wear people down. This is a good fighter he's in with here.
And Burke gave it everything. His game to the end. He could feel it going, he gave one last attack, and then Thaxton came once more, and this time it was too much.
It's just the right and then the left for the second knockdown. But his legs just sort of give way at this point, the right, the left. He's trying to fight back, Burke, but the legs just give way there. He's wilted under the pressure and the power of Thaxton.
It all happened from the end of the last round, didn't it? From then on, there was only going to be one winner, and when the first knockdown happened within the first 30 seconds of this round, it was all over. That was the end, and here was the celebration. Jon Thaxton retains his title.
Yes, the legs just betrayed him. He stopped throwing punches, Thaxton, at that point, but the legs betrayed him. He just sank to the canvas, and the referee was dead right to call it off. So an impressive outing for Jon Thaxton.
So good friends now. It was a good fight and a very impressive winner. Here's the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute, 20 seconds of round 9, the referee has stopped the contest. Paul Burke in no position to continue. The winner and still WBO and IBF Intercontinental Light Welterweight champion, Jonathan Thaxton.
A big hero here in Norwich is Jon Thaxton.
Ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation, please, for a very, very good loser indeed, please, for Paul Burke.
Yes, Burke fought gamely, but that, I would think, is very near the end of his career. Thaxton has his flaws. He's not the perfect package. He's defensively a little slack, but that kind of power, well, he could very nearly take him all the way.
Yes, he didn't get frustrated when his early attempts didn't get through. He just kept at it, and gradually he just started to wear him down, and the crowd certainly loved it. He's becoming a big hero here, and I'm sure that Frank Warren's going to bring him back to Norwich before too long.
It's amazing what confidence can do, and his career looked to be going nowhere until February of last year. Then one left hook, he knocked out Paul Scrap Iron Ryan, and from then on he's never looked back, and here he is now, the WBO and the IBF Intercontinental champion, and he's talking now with Adam Smith.
Jon Thaxton, congratulations, both belts retained in front of your beloved Norwich crowd.
What a crowd, you know, what a crowd. This is absolutely brilliant. I thank Frank Warren bringing big time boxing back to Norwich. My mum, everyone who's been selling the tickets, you know, thank you so much, all the help and support from the Oasis, everyone.
You persuaded Frank to bring boxing to Norwich, and you delivered.
I did. I said, Frank, we'll sell the place out. Well, I can't. I said, you know, we've done what I said to do. Thanks to my mum. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Frank. You know, great.
Now, you looked very keyed up before the fight. It was a bit of a chess match for the first sort of 5 or 6 rounds. Were you a bit frustrated with that?
Is that your big experience? I expected that. But I knew, just keep my game plan. My fitness was there. You know, I knew I'd get him. As soon as I let my punches go, I'd catch him. He just kept putting his head down a bit. It was awkward to catch the towel. That's experience. Great learning fight. Went 9 rounds. Banged him out in the 9th round. I still got the power after halfway stage. I got the power in the 9th, 10th, then 12th.
That's it. You cut him in the 6th. It seemed then you just took over from there.
You know, I listened to this crowd. Brilliant. You know, I came. I hit him one time and he wobbled. And I thought, yep, maritime. I'll take him. Just let me stop. And when I started on Logan with 4, 5, 6 punch combination, I got him.
They're all singing Jono, Jono, Frank. What a night. Unbelievable, isn't it? The atmosphere is tremendous here. Yeah, I'm delighted he convinced me to come here, and we'd certainly be back here again. I thought you were a little bit keyed up in the fight, trying a bit too hard, but once you relaxed, once he started letting those shots go, I mean, he took the fight well and won the fight well. And I'm sure he'll be back here with a world title fight in a not too distant future.
Well, that's it. John's been talking about a world title shot this year, possibly against Giovanni Brizzi. Can you arrange it?
Certainly I can. That's the business I'm in. I'll deliver the world title fight to him as I do to most fighters. He'll get his shot and he'll get it in his hometown. We will make sure we get it. Not going to happen straight away, but we'll certainly work hard on it. And hopefully we can deliver that. But it's been a tremendous night for Norwich. And the fans here have been great. They're great boxing fans. There's a real upsurge of boxing in the country. You know, everywhere we're going, we're selling out. This is tremendous tonight. Tremendous.
Well, you can hear it with the crowd, the Norwich crowd, and your mum. She sold every ticket for you.
Oh, you know, well, not just my mum. There's like Louise at the Oasis, Mark Whitworth, you know, a lot of people, AJ's, everybody, you know. I just thank everyone. Like Brendan, Dominic, John, got me in superb shape. You know, I could not let him down. Everyone, Oasis, Harry, you know, I thank everyone because everyone's been just brilliant and the build-up to the fight has been brilliant. You know, I can't believe it. I'm very happy, you know.
I can see that, John. Enjoy your night.
Thanks very much. Thank you. Thank you.